Salute here, everybody. Welcome to July 2020. Second half of the year is upon us. Let's go into our class now. Adult karate at home. So let's get ourselves warmed up. I'm going to do 20 jumping jacks. Ready, go. Take your feet and put them wide apart. Today we're going to be doing a little bit more work with the bow staff, okay? So if you have a stick or something like that, if you need to stop the recording and go get it after we get done stretching out, feel free. All right, so here we go. Feet, what do you say? Two shoulder widths apart and pick a leg. Go all the way down and get to your foot. Let that knee bend. Let's go to the other side. All right. Okay. Let's come back up again. And let's try a stretch to the center. Bring yourself up, and let's go down to our toes. Ooh, this is a tight one. All right, so just let yourself just kind of, for me anyway, I'm sure you're fine, but all the way down there. You can feel it all the way down to the tip of the toe, mainly the back of the knee. All right, bend your knees and come on back up again. All right, great. Now, drop down to one knee, and we'll just do a forward stretch. Reaching in, going inside that knee. And straighten that leg out and reach that down to your toes. All right, well, let's try the other side. Just bend that knee and reach on in. There we go, here we go. And reach on down to your toes. All right, let's talk about where we are. Well, we're right here. Let's talk about where we are. We're in the pandemic, in the midst of that. We still have class. We're doing this using Zoom technology. YouTube has the same kind of thing. I want to start working with that, but for direct recording. But what I just wanted to say, I'm going to keep doing these twice a week. And anywhere from 20 to 30 or plus minutes. I'm going to I want to, as ideas we get moving forward, I want to say is have shorter videos too that take in maybe little training bits and pieces. If you're a perfectionist like me, there's certain things you want to get down right, and maybe certain things that we don't cover very often. Are they important? No, but they're just, like I said, they're just kind of rounding the corners, making things a little smoother. You know, they're just little insights. You know, where do I put my feet? How do I hold my hands? You know, just the whole trying to be a complete black belt student and stuff. So that's what we're looking to be. All right, so today is, we're going to start out with the bow staff. And so I've got mine off camera here. I am back. All right, so I wanted to show a couple things here. Well, first off, again, going over the grip. And right hand on top. I know I'm in mirror connection here, but putting the right hand on top, left hand on the bottom. If I move my hands closer together, I have a little bit more flexibility and rotation and everything. And so pull apart, obviously, I'm going to have a stronger grip. Just to give you some something I want to work on today with an inverted grip, I want you to take your index finger and your middle finger, like a peace sign or like an oar lock, and grab your bow or stick or whatever, broom handle, kind of like this. Now my fingers are free, I can hang on to it in this fashion, right? What does that give me? It gives me a little bit of flexibility on how I can manipulate the bow around me. So what I want to do here, I'm going to hold it high, and I want to take my hands, I want to cross them over. I want to take my left hand forward and take my right hand forward. Now we don't normally do it this way. One of my students and we had as an instructor years ago, Cole Hess, taught me how to do this, and I thought it was a real quick way. I thought it was really a shortcut on how to learn how to use a bow quick. And so, yeah, I'm not sure where he got it from. I'm just going to say he invented it. How about that? We'll go like so. I can rotate this over my head. So if I take my left hand up, I'm going to point my left hand out in front of me, and I just push my right hand down, okay? Just like so. So I don't have to worry about how I grip the bow. I just have it loosely between my two fingers here so it can kind of float back and forth. If I do it the other way, I can go in and being able to bring the bow around my head, so to speak, okay? Without blocking reverse strike, blocking forward, you know, reverse or forward strike and such. So what I wanted to show you here is taking this like so, is putting my left hand on top and my right hand on the bottom. So I'm going to go in and do we'll call it an inverted block here. All right, so take my left hand and put it down, kind of like I'm going to clap my hands together. But I'm not going to bring my hands together necessarily. I'm just going to allow it in this position. If I put my right leg in front, I get something that looks like this, all right? And what you're seeing here is kind of like where my finger will go underneath. I got it across my palm now. I'll grab it. This one will go over the top. So then when I do it this way, I have my hands this way. So this one kind of turns in, kind of works to the outside, rotates outward. Is that cranks to the right? So my thumb goes up. So I'm going to be in this position here. So instead of being, so if I'm here, I'm kind of like a neutral grip, I can just pull my hands up. My hands don't get confused. With my left hand on top, and my right hand on the bottom, I want to be here. Let's say I strike with my right side, and then I just lift my left hand over my head. All right? And so I'm going to be in this position here. This could be an end point, or it could be a midpoint. So what we want to practice here, let's say if I'm doing Shushin no Kan, which is introductory or the first form of Matayoshi Kabuto here with the bow staff, I'm going to strike with my right foot. I'm going to say that again. Strike with my right hand. Strike with the right end of my bow staff here. Pull back and strike out here. Okay? Now from there, let's say I'm in this position here. If I needed to go an inverted block like I do in the second form, I can go from this position, all right? So we'll go like so here. We're gonna strike, boom, bang, like so. And then from here, we're gonna pull back and crank it out this way. Just a fun little exercise for today. I'm gonna go up here. Maybe I'll bring this into a cat stance and I push out here this way. Now what in tarnation is a cat stance? Well, I bring my foot back, I get up on the ball of my foot, so my heel is up. So somewhat resembles a cat's leg, I guess. So this is called a cat stance, alrighty? Most of my weight is on my back leg. My guess is this is done so that, and I'm probably wrong, is done so that if this leg is struck at, it's easy to get out of the way. Whereas if it's here, I've got to shift my weight quite back, and I might be late, and I might get my leg knocked out with the bow. So I'm going to go like so here. I'm going to come in. Let's say we get in our defensive stance like we talked about last time. Right hand up. It's kind of like if I put my bow down, I got my hands up in a punching position. Up here, I step in, I strike, like so. All right, so now from here, this position here, we were going with a hook block this way. What if I came into here, and then I slid up to here, and then I came back to here again? So we can just kind of make up a little pattern here, all right? So we can go in, we can step, we can go back, we can, let's say we jab with that left hand, strike with the right, come back and block, step in and strike. Come back and block, and strike again, just like that, all right? Yeah, I think that works. How about you? Yeah. No answer? All right, great. Well, all right, keep it to yourself then. Here we go. So I'm going to be like so. Let's say, instead of going down, let's improvise here and strike forward. Strike forward. Lock here. Strike here. Pull back. Drive. And maybe block here again, just to kind of give it a semblance of what we've already practiced. Okay? So I'm sitting there like so. Let's do it three more times. One. So pop here, drive, block high, strike, drive, and return block. Okay? Ready? And two. Strike, strike, block, strike. Set up here. Wait a minute. Wait, we got to come back and drive. Yeah. And then come to here. All right. Forgot my improvisation. Okay. Let's try that again. So we're going in. Drive it. I can rock it. Hit it. Push. And finish up here. Now, there's no written rule. Nothing has to be done a certain way. I'm just making it up. Okay. Just having some fun with it. So if you want to improvise and do it a different way, have at it. Go in. Strike here. Hit. Boom, bang. And then if we wanted to, we could strike down low. Oh, let's do that. Let's add a little something, a little flavor to it, okay? So we go here. One motion is from this position here, I come in, I'm going to take that leg out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick this bow up, so put my feet wide apart, and sweep that leg out of the way. And I'm going to do that by taking my right hand over top of my left. So it crosses over, just like so. So what do we got here? I got this hook block, got my elbow up high, move my right leg to the side, bow's out in front of me, take my right hand, which is right here, push it over the top. Trip the leg out, you know, I can come back into this position. You step in and strike again. I'm kind of taking pieces of a couple of different bow forms and just kind of freestyling them a little bit. That's kind of fun. So let's do the whole, well, let's add that piece on and see if something else will appear. Maybe we can add it together and just have something we can do kind of like in-house, not too long, kind of fun. Well, kind of fun, but it's a lot of fun. Left leg in front, jab, and then strike. And then we block, and then strike. And then drive back, thrust forward, block again. Now we're going to drop it wide, block a strike here, trip, and come back up out of here. And maybe then after then we can start to work the figure eight if you want to get fancy. My apologies to all the traditionalists out there, okay? So we go in, we come back to here through, all right? So how do you do a figure eight? It's, well, I don't know if it's worth a whole lot, but it is or it isn't. It is fun to do though. Thumb travels, sideways eight, okay? And that's what we want to practice with. So as I take my thumb over, my bow is extra light, so I can just roll my hand around and go around here, just like so. And if this is too hard or doesn't make sense, not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. So what I can do is do a partial figure eight. Like, let's say I'm here. What do? We drive in, come back to here. Maybe I'm going to go figure eight a little bit, and I pull it to my left side, and I just thrust out here. All right, so I'm gonna go in. Neutral stance, my feet are just kind of like together. And then as I pull my right hand from the bottom up here, I just step with it, you know? Okay. So, playing around, what we do? We, all right, we're in defensive stance, we jab, and we struck here. Block high, struck here. Then we came back and we did it in a second, a third time. Come up here, the block. And then, okay, we can go up high, or we can just go right into this cut. And then from here, we go up and just go around. And one more little innovation. I just step with my right, and I just spin around, and I got a spinning figure eight. That might be hard to do at home. It might be hard to do, period. So when I do this, as I turn my hand down, boink, I point my... I use my thumb as a guide. My thumb goes down. I'm gonna bring it over to here, like so. I'm just gonna snap my thumb up. At the same time, zoop, into this position here. Where was I again? I was right here. I went out here, I turned my thumb down, like I'm doing a punch, and then I go down, yep. I'm gonna bring it back, like so. What about this? I gotta bring my legs around. So as I bring it back, I turn, I catch it on the way around, come this way. All right, so not that hard, but it's very difficult until you get it right, until you get it. So how do I do it? So I don't want it to, I never want this to swing to weakness where my hand turns out so it's almost like a wrist lock. I just want to make sure I turn it so I have control of it. And so I'm going to go down here. Let me see now again. I'm going to take my bow and put it out here in front of me. The simplest way I know how to do this is barehanded. It's just one hand. I turn my thumb down. When I do that, I turn my foot. So I'm gonna go like I'm punching here. So you see how the bow rotates. Well, let's put my foot in there with it too. We go here, like so. Now this is coming back here. I keep stepping my finger back here because it's lonely and it wants some attention paid to it, okay? So my right hand comes back to my left, just like that, as my left leg goes around behind me. So I go here and step around. Doing that in two parts, I get one look. When I do it all in one part, it looks like this, I think. Go here, and now I'm grabbing it actually as I come around the front. I get it this way. So if I'm able to figure eight, and if I want to keep my back leg behind me, I step and punch, bring it around, and I go here, and I can step through and thrust, and I can go back to the whole shebang again, okay? So, you know, whatever. But I think learning here, you know, learning the combination, I think we practice this on Monday, where you go down low, poke the foot, strike to the knee, strike to the neck, drive straight out, block the counterattack. We do that again and again and again. We're not taking today and just freestyling it a little bit so that we are more in a natural defensive stance. I jab and I strike. Okay. Now I could do another punch there too, but we're not going to today. All right. That could be fun next time. Here, just like so. I want to, so I strike in here with my right, like this. Now I'm gonna block, and I pull my front foot back, and then I pull and give a big monster strike with my right hand. Pull back, and thrust out again, and block the counter strike. Now, just to give it some flavor, we go up, and we are doing a crossover, coming up, and then maybe doing a figure eight, if you want. And then maybe step around and go here. If I do the figure eight with both hands, same thing. My hands just stay close together. As I turn my hand down, my left hand stays close by, and it's right there when I come back around again. All right, now if that throws you off a little bit, don't worry about it. I just think it might be kind of fun. Let's put this down. And let's come on back. Alrighty. Remember I was talking about making short videos in the first part of here. I do want to definitely review some different parts of our forms. Now, they have to deal with the turn and our stances. So first off, we're going through a straight line version of Hian Shodan. All right, let's just get there. Let's start here. So we're all on the same page. I'm doing the three-quarter stance here. Going to my left and to my right. So we go bow, ready stance, Hian Shodan. I go in, get my front leg bent, step through with my punch, come in with my right, hammer strike. I'm gonna pull my leg back on the hammer, put it back in place when you go to punch. So you step here, punch, I go forward, keep your weight low. One, two, Now here's where I wanna be. Let me scooch back here a little bit. I want to take my left leg and bring it around. At the same time, I take my left hand and block it down. Okay, so if I'm here with the high right, I'm going to be here with the left. Where does this left hand go? From here, do a down block, my hand's got to come up. So I'm going to be here in this position here, here in this position here. I'm going to have my right hand up. And as I go, my hands are going to cross over, so my left hand's high, I come down. And step and punch. Boom. Right down, step and punch. Boom. And down here. Three shots. One, two, and three. Now we come around with a knife. And two. Three. And four. All right, so that second transition is back here. Let's spin the world around. I'm going to be hit with three punches. I hit with my right. I hit with my left. And hit with my right again. Now my left hand is gonna go down and again do a down block. Oh, different form. It's gonna go here and do a knife hand block. So I'm gonna have my punch here. My left leg comes around, where I get my lineup. I wanna get my stance, cross my arms and chop. Okay. If I confuse you with my foot placement, let's go back and make it a little more straight out here. Right hand here. Now everything comes into the center here as I bring myself around this way, just like so, and I get my knife hand block. All right, it is these two transitions, three-quarter turn, that I wanted to work on today, sitting up here. So we're here, weight forward, weight just stays on this right leg. Boom, and it gets back to here again. All right, hands come across. One more time, let me scooch a bit, I hit. And then I fold and chop. All right. What's great about the form Hian Shodan, it's so darn simple, but it helps you get your footwork. I should say, to really get a good understanding of balance. And let's go into the second form, Hian Nidan, level two. And it has the same transitions. Hian Nidan is in the beginning. Let's just start from the beginning. Let's move over here this time. Bow here, Hian Nidan. Hands go to my right, and they block up, punch, strike. Go with my left hand up high, punch, strike. Bring my feet up, cup and saucer with my hands. Side kick and back fist. One, two, three. All right, so I want to be here now. I want to push this hand down. Sorry about that. I'm glad I cracked my shoulder. Here, push this hand down and spear hand. There we go. All the parts are okay. So now at this part here, I'm going to turn and knife hand. So my hands come up, chop one and two, like so. Easy transition here. I just go from a 45 degree to a 90. Block out and kick. Block out and kick. Now I step into a back stance now. Right hand in front, turn, and do a down block. And then into a 45 degree high block. Down block, 45 degree high block. And come back. Okay. Hian. Sandan. Well, that only has one turn, and it's kind of goofy. The turn at the very end, where we're going to go hammer strike, step and punch, that's just about bringing our feet together. It's no big deal. We get to the very end here. We come into here, we strike, and then we step with our left leg and punch. Now, to make this transition, I'm going to get my left leg over there. So it's got to be all the way around to here. Well, golly. Take this foot, step up, or step across, and then make this transition easier. So here I am. Let me get somewhere close that you can see me. I get to the end of Sandan. What do I got? Left side in front. Pow. I get this here. Bring this foot up. I come around, get my heels in the right place, and I get work on my elbow strike to the body and that hand flying over the shoulder to the head. And then shift it. Do the same. All right, that's how we get that. All right? Okay. And let's just leave those in. Let's just leave that there. I wanted those three forms, bang, bang, bang. I think those have especially the first two, the transition is the most important. I think it's the toughest part. I just remember practicing it again and again. And maybe you got it right away, but I really had a hard time with it. So I'm thinking maybe somebody else might have a hard time. And if there's anything else you do, just let me know. Give me an email. And if you have any questions, we'll go over it and stuff. All right, so let's finish up with a kick combination. Now, I'm not going to go real razzle-dazzle here on anything like this. I just wanted to take you through this, and you can build it on your own here, okay? But let's build some combinations up with three kicks. Now, you know, if I can take and put those three kicks, I got two different legs doing three different kicks. I got all kinds of variations. I got to do the factorial on that, but I can't quite remember what it is. But it's got to be a lot of combinations, don't you think? I've got my front leg, I've got my back leg. So let's go like this here. Here's the simple way. Let me get a pad out for visualization. And so you can see where I'm going. You don't need a pad, but if you have one, that'd be cool. All right, so now, I'll leave this to you, but I'm going to give you some versions of this. We have, well, let me try it this way. I like to put my left side in front, so I want to be able to face you. So I'm going to be here now, all right? So I'm on the side of the pad here. My back leg is going to front kick. Bang. Simple, right? Now, where does it go? Does it go here and back? Yeah, yes, it can. Does it go here and in front? Again, yes. Now, if I go back here, it's going to be hard to hit it with my front leg. If I go front here, I'm too close to kick it. All right, so the peculiarities of the pad, I got to work the circle. All right, so if I'm going like this here, this combination like this, my back leg comes up in front kicks. And now I set it down, and think about a circle that goes around the pad. I want to set it down to the side, like I'm going to walk around the pad this way. My other leg comes up, and it's in perfect position to strike. All right, so I have front kick, and I have a off to the side round kick. So I go front kick, and then I'm off to the side. And this has a lot of practicality, too. Because if I'm coming straight at an opponent, I'm in his line of fire here. You know, nothing more frustrating than being on one foot and somebody giving you a kick. It knocks you right off your feet. And it doesn't necessarily hurt, but it does discombobulate you. It can hurt, though. Let's add in the side kick here. Front leg. I'm sorry. Let's try that again. Back leg, front kick, round kick. Now, this foot just touches, and I can hit it with a side kick in the mid-body. All right, so if I have this combination, it seems like it works well. One, two, three. Now, if you're really balanced, you can go one, two, three. Put a little pause in there just for effect. You can do it that way. Now, if you want to do all three kicks, or two kicks on one leg, you can go front, pivot, and round. All right, so I'm going to give a feint going low, and then I'm a pi, right? So I have the thing of this inside, the different kick, I can put them all in any way I want to. I go off my front leg, one, two, three. Just don't stagger like I was just doing. So I'm gonna go hit one, two, three. Whee! Oh, I thought I was gonna stay up. Okay. See, anybody can knock the pad over, but can you get it just on the edge so it snaps back? That's the trick. Now, moving on here. I can do the same basic kick set. One, two, three. Or I can do the first two kicks the same. Now the third kick, I do off my backside, off the right hand coming around here, right? And I hit the front side. So I have a different variation. You have the ability to do this. Hit here, hit here, hit here. You get a pretty good combination. But look where I landed. I landed with my back to the pad. Incorrect. Okay, get yourself here. One, two, three. And set yourself up so you can hit. Rule of thumb, or rule of punching and kicking. If you're gonna punch, end up so that you can kick. You know, so you start with one, work to the other. You're gonna start with the kicks, set it up so that you can punch. Never leave yourself hanging unless you're doing a completely walk-away defensive kick or whatever. So use these in combination here. And you can do this. My recommendations are to do, well, this combination in this way, all right? I did four or five here. Let's do this one today, all right? I wish I could do bullet points on the side, but I don't have any graphic ability with Zoom. Front kick with the back leg, off to the side, round kick. If you like, you can side kick. So if I'm in the mirror, one, two, three. All right, if I want to use my hands after that, I can go one, two, I can go right into my punches here. Works really well. If I go to side kick, I guess I can go into my punches too, but it doesn't work as well. All right, so if I recommend if you want to do punches, just do the first two kicks. Boom, 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 and do three. All right, they work better. Cross, cross, cross. All righty. If you wanted to just do all kicks, front kick, round kick, front side kick works really well. And again, if I'm doing that, I want to leave myself in a position to throw my punches as I get done with that. Okay? All righty. Now, here ends the lesson. Where'd my head go? Oh, there it is. Okay, you have a great night, great week, and hope we'll see each other soon someday. Any other announcements? I'm going to keep the schedule the same. I keep trying to have some other supplementary stuff. I'm going to be working on that in July. Okay? Salute here. Stay strong, everybody. Wash your hands. Okay? All right.